同学们好，今天我们来学习第143课，也是本次书的最后一个教学单元。Lesson 143, A Walk Through the Woods. We'll look at a story about people who throw litter. 这个小故事是关于一个美丽的小镇的，但是与此不相符的是到处乱丢的垃圾。一起来看课文，并且回答这样一个问题。What was so funny about the words on the sign? 牌子上的字有什么可笑的地方？
I live in a very old town, which is surrounded by beautiful woods. It is a famous beauty spot. On Sundays, hundreds of people come from the city to see our town and to walk through the woods. Visitors have been asked to keep the woods clean and tidy.Litter baskets have been placed under the trees, but people still throw their rubbish everywhere. Last Wednesday, I went for a walk in the woods. What I saw made me very sad. I counted 7 old cars and 3 old refrigerators. The litter baskets were empty, and the ground was covered with pieces of paper, cigarette ends, old tires, empty bottles,and rusty tins. Among the rubbish, I found a sign which said, Anyone who leaves litter in these woods will be prosecuted.
下面请大家回答这个问题。What was so funny about the words on the sign? The sign said, Anyone who leaves litter in these woods will be prosecuted. But the sign was right among the rubbish. 牌子上写着任何在这个树林中丢弃垃圾者都将被依法处置，但是牌子本身却在一堆垃圾中间。好，下面我们一起来看本课中的关键词和词组，请跟我读。Keywords and expressions: surround, beauty spot, visitor, litter basket, throw, rubbish, count, cover.Tire, rusty, prosecute. 一起来看课文中的主要语言点。I live in a very old town, which is surrounded by beautiful woods. 我住在一个有美丽的树林环绕的古老小镇上。It is a famous beauty spot. 这是一个著名的风景胜地。Woods, 小树林。如果是比较大的森林，我们可以说 forest.Beauty spot, 风景胜地。我们还可以说 tourist attraction, 意思是一样的。Be surrounded, 被什么什么环绕。来看两个例句。I live in a place which is surrounded by tall buildings. 我住在一个被高大建筑环绕的地方。I live in a village which is surrounded by hills. 我住在一个四周环山的小山村。有很多的游客到小镇上游览，并且在林中散步，为了保护环境，对他们提出了这样的要求。Visitors have been asked to keep the woods clean and tidy. 游客们已被告知要保持树林的整洁。Have been asked 是一个现在完成时的被动语态，意思是已被告知做某件事情。Keep the woods clean and tidy, 保持树林的整洁。Litter baskets have been placed under the trees, but people still throw their rubbish everywhere. 在树下已经设置了废物筐，但是人们仍然到处乱丢垃圾。Litter baskets, 废物筐。Litter 还可以做动词用，比如说 Don't litter, 不要到处乱丢杂物。Have been placed, 已被放置，这是一个现在完成时的被动语态。Place, 放置。来看两个例句。He placed his hand on my shoulder. 他把他的手放在我的肩上。A box has been placed on the counter. 一个盒子已经被放置在柜台上了。本课中出现的被动语态有了更多的时态变化。下面我们来看两个例句，一个是一般将来时的被动语态，一个是现在完成时的被动语态。You'll be asked to show your passport at the customs office. 在海关你将被要求出示护照。 Will be asked 是一个一般将来时的被动语态。 I've never been asked to do things I don't like. 我从来没有被要求做我不喜欢做的事情。Have been asked 是一个现在完成时的被动语态。Last Wednesday, I went for a walk in the woods. What I saw made me very sad. 上个星期三，我到树林里去散步了。我所见的一切让我非常的伤心。Go for a walk, 去散步。我们还可以说 take a walk。What I saw 是一个主语从句，也就是说用了一个句子来做主语，而不是一个词。再来看一个类似的例子。What she did surprised us. 她所做的一切让我们觉得很吃惊。那么作者为什么觉得难过呢？她又看到了什么呢？ The little baskets were empty, and the ground was covered with pieces of paper, cigarette ends, old tires, empty bottles,and rusty tins. 废物箱是空的，但是满地都是纸片、烟头、旧轮胎、空瓶子和生锈的空罐子。Rusty, 生锈的，它还有一个引申的意义。比如说，如果你的英语很长时间没有练习了，现在有点生疏了，你可以这样来说 My English is rusty. 这种说法非常的形象。Be covered with, 布满了什么东西。比如说 The furniture is covered with dust. 家具上满是灰尘。The road is covered with snow. 路上都是积雪。最可笑的是在垃圾中间还有一块这样的牌子。Among the rubbish, I found a sign which said, Anyone who leaves litter in these woods will be prosecuted. 凡在此树林中丢弃垃圾者将被依法处置。Said 在这的意思并不是说，而是写着。比如说 The book doesn't say where he was born. 书上并没有写他是在哪出生的。The clock says 3 o'clock. 钟表指向三点钟。Prosecute 起诉，依法处置。比如说 Trespassers will be prosecuted. 擅自入内者将被起诉。Will be prosecuted是一般将来时的被动语态。在本科中我们学习了如何在现在完成时以及一般将来时当中使用被动语态。下面我们来总结一下本科的基本句型。Has or have been 已经被， Will be 将被。来看一组例句。 The rooms haven't been cleaned yet. 房间还没有被打扫。They will be cleaned soon. 他们将很快就被打扫。我们在上个教学单元中学到过被动语态的基本构成是 be 加上过去分词。那么体现在现在完成时当中，根据人称的不同， be 要变化成 has been 或者 have been， 后面加上过去分词。而在一般将来时当中， be 要变化成 will be， 后面加上过去分词。下面我们再来看一遍课文，请大家跟读，并且注意作者是怎样表达已经被或者将被这两种意思的。
I live in a very old town, which is surrounded by beautiful woods. It is a famous beauty spot. On Sundays, hundreds of people come from the city to see our town and to walk through the woods. Visitors have been asked to keep the woods clean and tidy.Litter baskets have been placed under the trees, but people still throw their rubbish everywhere. Last Wednesday, I went for a walk in the woods. What I saw made me very sad. I counted 7 old cars and 3 old refrigerators. The litter baskets were empty, and the ground was covered with pieces of paper, cigarette ends, old tires, empty bottles,and rusty tins. Among the rubbish, I found a sign which said, Anyone who leaves litter in these woods will be prosecuted.
接下来我们进入句型训练，来练习一下如何在现在完成时以及一般将来时当中使用被动语态。请特别注意助动词的选择。Lesson 144. He hasn't been served yet. He will be served soon.Repair. Hasn't anyone repaired this car yet? It has already been repaired. Dust. Hasn't anyone dusted the dressing table yet? It has already been dusted. Correct. Hasn't anyone corrected these exercise books yet? They have already been corrected. Catch. Hasn't anyone caught the thief yet? He hasn't been caught yet. He will be caught soon. Open. Hasn't anyone opened the window yet? It hasn't been opened yet. It will be opened soon. Catch. Hasn't anyone caught the thieves yet? They haven't been caught yet. They will be caught soon. 到今天为止，新概念英语第一册英语初阶 First things first， 我们就全部学习完了。相信在轻松活泼的场景中，大家已经学会了很多可以在日常生活中实际应用的语言。学习一门语言，不仅仅是要掌握一套规则，积累大量的词汇，更重要的是能够使用这门语言。如果你想掌握更多的表达思想的方法，那么就要在听说读写等各个方面加强练习。你也可以继续学习新概念英语第二册实践与进步 Practice and Progress。 好了，再次感谢您和我一起来学习。 Thank you and goodbye.